The eyes of Big Brother just got a little larger. A U.S. district judge ruled it was reasonable for Drug Enforcement Administration agents to enter rural property without permission.
What we're getting is thousands and millions of dollars being spent on surveilling some youths who are growing some plants in a field. We're using high-tech equipment, which is 10 years ago would be discounted.
The judge sided with the Justice Department, saying it was reasonable for DEA agents to secretly install multiple surveillance cameras. Groups with legal challenges against the U.S. government say the intrusion wouldn't require special permission or a warrant.
What we're trying to do is really sort of pull back the curtain on what the government is doing and what the Department of Homeland Security is doing and the level of data collection that's going on and monitoring and surveillance and coordination.
The case out of Wisconsin originated from video evidence taken from two men who were growing marijuana on their property in an open field. The two men now face life imprisonment and fines of up to $10 million. The case ruling indicates a modification in privacy expectations from the federal government. The impact of the judge's ruling is yet to be determined, but this latest case examines how technology is forcing the U.S. legal system to rethink Americans' privacy rights and how they're protected by the laws of the land. As technology gets smaller, concerns stemming from government surveillance continues to rise. This week's ruling comes as civil liberties advocates are heavily criticizing the government's abridgment of Fourth Amendment rights, prohibiting unreasonable searches of the public.
It's not supposed to be a massive spying juggernaut focused on its own citizenry. And that's what we have. You know, they use the guise of terrorism or terrorism as a pretext, and it extends well beyond that.
According to government documents retrieved by the American Civil Liberties Union, the Justice Department's use of warrantless phone and internet surveillance has increased 600% over the past decade. Colin Campbell, Press TV, Washington.